Take a look at the picture on the screen. Over here, you can see the sky. Now, we have studied that when the sun gives out light, it gives out white light. But from your day-to-day observations, you have seen that the sky appears blue in color. Now, if the sun is giving out white light, why does the sky appear blue in color? Why does it not appear white in color? We shall soon find out. Before we get to the depth of this interesting mystery, let us consider a very mind-boggling fact. Did you know that the distance of the Earth from the Sun is 150 million kilometers? This distance is such a huge distance, and it is the distance which the light rays have to cover in order to travel from the Sun to the Earth. That is 150 million kilometers. Now, we have studied that the sun emits all kinds of electromagnetic waves. It emits gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible light that consists of 7 components, and also infrared rays, microwaves, and radio waves. Now, all these together are emitted by the sun. Now, what do you think happens once they reach Earth? If you recall from our earlier discussions, you will remember that we human beings are unable to perceive infrared rays, microwaves, radio waves, UV rays, X-rays, and gamma rays. Now, even though infrared rays, microwaves, and radio waves enter the Earth's atmosphere, we are unable to perceive them. And the Earth's atmosphere blocks out most of the UV rays and almost all of gamma rays and X-rays. But the Earth's atmosphere lets in visible light, and as we have studied, we human beings can perceive visible light that consists of 7 colors. Now let us find out what was happening in the case and why the sky is appearing blue. Consider an animation. We have learned previously that all colors in the visible light spectrum can be composed of 3 primary colors. These 3 primary colors are red, green, and blue. So using red, green, and blue, we can derive any color based on their relative composition. So here we consider red light, green light, and blue light incident on the atmosphere of the Earth. Now let us find out what happens after they are incident. Now before we consider that, look at the animation. In this animation, a rope has been tied to the tree and the other end of the rope is held in a person's hand. Now, when the person moves the rope up and down less vigorously, longer wavelengths are created. As a result, the number of waves passing through at any given point at a time is less, so it is hitting the mango or the orange on the tree less. Similarly, if the person at the other end is jerking the rope up and down more vigorously, wavelengths of shorter length are created, and the number of waves passing through any given point at any particular time is more. And as a result, the orange or mango on the tree is getting hit more number of times. Now, scientist Rayleigh had discovered a very important observation. Lord Rayleigh, as he was called, discovered that when the wavelength of a particular wave is less, it scatters more. And when the wavelength of a particular wave is large, the scattering of that wave is less. This is the relation that Lord Rayleigh had found out. And he had also observed a scientific or mathematical relation along with it. The mathematical relation stated that intensity of scattering is inversely proportional to the fourth power of wavelength. In other words, the intensity of scattering is directly proportional to 1 by lambda to the power 4. Here, lambda is the wavelength of the wave that is being considered. So now we consider these 3 waves, that is the 3 different colors, red, green, and blue. Now, from our earlier discussions, you will recall that red had the highest wavelength, followed by the wavelength of green, and lastly, the wavelength of blue. So among these three colors, red has the highest wavelength, followed by that of green, and then at the end we have blue. So red has the highest wavelength and blue has the lowest wavelength. So here we see that red light is scattered very less when passing through the atmosphere. Just as Lord Rayleigh had put forward his relation, red light, which has a very large wavelength, is scattered to a very, very less extent, and we can say that is almost not scattered. Because the wavelength of red light is maximum, it easily passes through the dust particles and molecules that are present in the atmosphere. As a reason, it is very less scattered. If we have to judge this situation with the help of the formula, we can say that since the wavelength of red light is much more, the denominator in this case will be very high, so this entire expression will be very low, and as a result, the intensity of scattering is very low. Similarly, we consider the case for green light. Green light has a wavelength that is less than that of red light. So since the wavelength of green light is less than that of red light, according to what Rayleigh had said, it will be scattered more. So as you can see, as compared to red, green is getting scattered more. It is actually colliding with the dust particles and the molecules that are present inside the medium. That is, it is getting reflected off their surfaces and getting scattered. So it is scattered more than red light. Likewise, if we have to judge this situation based on the formula, we can say that the wavelength of green is less as compared to that of red. So this fraction will evaluate to a value that is more than that for red. So we can say that the intensity of scattering is more for green than it was for red. Lastly, if we consider blue light, we can see that it is getting scattered to a very large extent. Why? Because the wavelength of blue light is the least among red, green, and blue. So since the wavelength of blue light is very less than that of red, that is, it is the minimum in case of the three, it collides with the dust particles and molecules, and it is scattered the most or to a very large extent. Similarly, if we have to judge this situation based on the formula, we can say that since the wavelength of blue light is minimum or is very less, the denominator is very less as compared to the other two cases, and the entire fraction is more as compared to that for red or even green. So the intensity of scattering for blue is much more than that of green or red. So when red, green, and blue light are passing through the Earth's atmosphere, red passes by almost without no scattering or very little amount of scattering. Green light, on the other hand, undergoes a greater amount of scattering. But blue light, as we saw, because it has the lowest wavelength, undergoes the maximum amount of scattering. So after scattering in the Earth's atmosphere, this blue light reaches Earth. And on Earth, it reaches our eyes. So it is due to this reason that the sky or the atmosphere seems blue to us. Now you must be wondering that when you see movies which deal with outer space or where you see astronauts walking on moon, why do you think that the astronauts are able to see the blue sky? This is because the moon or the outer space has no atmosphere. There is complete vacuum there and there are no medium particles. So when sunlight is falling over here, there is no scattering, and as a result, no color reaches the astronaut's eyes. And it is due to this reason that an astronaut sees the sky around him completely black. And it is also due to this reason that in movies, you see that the color of the sky in outer space is depicted as black. Now, you must have observed that when the sun is rising in the morning or it is setting in the evening, the color of the sky no longer remains blue. It becomes a very deep hue of orange and red. So why do you think this happens? We just discussed why the color of the sky was appearing blue and not red. So now why is it appearing red and not blue? Let us see. During sunrise or sunset, the position of the earth, that is at that particular point on the earth where sunrise or sunset is taking place, is such that the distance from the earth to the sun is maximum. That is, during a day, the distance from the sun to earth is maximum during sunrise and sunset. So as a result, light has to travel a very long distance in order to reach earth. Now we have studied that blue light is scattered the most, green light is scattered relatively less than blue light, and red light is not scattered at all or is scattered very less. Now since it has to travel a very long distance, you can see from the animation what is happening. When blue light is traveling such a long distance, it is getting scattered and not reaching the surface of the earth from the atmosphere. On the other hand, green light is also getting scattered, but not as much as blue light. And lastly, we see that red light is passing through the atmosphere without any scattering and is reaching the surface of the earth. So it is due to this reason that at sunrise and sunset, we are able to see the color of the sky as red.